This conference will now be recorded.
So, coming to me, so I have around 14 years of experience, 14 plus years of experience in Pega. Okay, so totally into Pega only. So my complete experience is in Pega only. Okay, so and even I gave many of the Pega trainings also earlier. Okay, so this is not my first batch. So and even there are some videos in YouTube, I think. So I've already recorded and played it some about the basics of the PHP standard. Okay, so that is coming to me. So let's start. So Harsha, so have you joined today only or you joined in the earlier one also?
Actually, I joined for a few like few minutes in the earlier part of the demo class. Like actually, I have a little bit of I'm working at the time. Actually, my timings are not matching at the time, so I just skipped the class. So I just went in the middle, and I
Okay,
just
okay.
came back. I just saw the recording which has been posted in the YouTube. I just saw it. So
Okay, nice.
yeah.
Yeah, fine. So now today, so we'll be going in detail about that Pega. So in the first one, so we just had a introduction about the PRPC, how what is the history, and again how what are the versions of the Pega. Okay, so how the Pega journey started, and later even the what do you mean by BPM, what do you mean by Pega rules, all these things we learned. Okay, so now today we will be getting into the actual subject of the PRPC. Okay, so for this, so have you people installed Pega in your systems? Do you have the Pega software, Pega 8.5?
We have Pega. I have Pega Infinity, I think, personal edition.
Yeah, Pega Infinity. Okay, which version of the Pega you have it?
I think 8.1 or something. What is it? I think the latest one. I'm not sure.
Okay, the latest version is 8.5, but
Yeah, I
even if
think.
you even if you have 8.1, 8.2 also, it doesn't make much difference. But if you compare with the 7.2 versions and the 8.0 version, they are completely different. But in the 8.8 version, okay, 8.1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. Okay, there are some new features has been added, but if possible, yeah, you can go ahead and install this. Okay, otherwise, yeah, you can go with the 8.1 version also, whichever you have, that is fine, no problem. Okay, but if you want to install the 8.5 version, you have to either you can go with the 8.1 or and the 8.5, both the versions also you can have it in your laptop, but it takes more memory. So if your laptop supports both the versions, then you can go ahead with that. Okay, so generally, whenever we install the Pega version, so it's very pretty straightforward to install the Pega software. But I think if you have the admin access in your laptop, most probably if it is your personal laptop, you'll be having the admin access. Otherwise, maybe yeah, you may have to have the admin access to install the any software in your laptop. Okay, so
So
and
like
whenever
once we complete the session, if you could help me, to install the software, it'd be great help.
yeah, definitely, I will help you. But as I said, if you have the admin access, yeah, definitely you can install, and I will try to help you in that.
Sure, sir.
Sure. And coming to today's session, so as I said that, okay, if you have the 8.1 version or 8.5 version, so whenever you install the software, right, so what you will be having is you will be having mainly three icons on your desktop. Okay, so in the desktop, mainly you'll be having three icons. So the one is, okay, so Pega Platform 8.5.1 login, Pega Platform 8.5.1 shutdown, and Pega Platform 8.5.1 startup. Okay, so mainly you'll be seeing these three icons in your desktop. Okay, so this is like it is running the server in your laptop. So first you need to start the server, Pega Platform 8.5.1 startup. So once you select this one, once you double click on this, so it is going to open the command prompt with this like this. Okay, so and it will take around 2 minutes to start the server. Okay, so once after starting the server, okay, then you can go ahead and log in into the portal. So to log in into the portal, you can use this Pega Platform 8.5.1 login. Okay, so then it is going to start the Pega portal. So like this, it will take local host colon 8080 slash PR web PR servlet. I hope you are able to see my screen. Okay, so in this, okay, it will ask you for the credentials to log in into the Pega portal. You see like this. And what do you mean by Pega portal? Pega portal means it's like a Pega website on which we are going to log in and we are going to start the development. Okay, so even not only the Pega portal, in general, if you discuss what you mean by portal, Amazon is one portal. Okay, even if you have any account in any of the bank, okay, like ICICIbank.com, so that is also one of the portal. So if you want to make any transactions, first what we will do, we will be going into the portal. After opening the portal, we will be logging into with our credentials. Okay, so to make all our transactions, first of all, we need to log in into the portal. In the same way, here in Pega 8.5.1 also, okay, otherwise in any of the Pega version. So first we need to log in into the portal. Okay, even to create a new application, otherwise if you want to make any changes in the existing application also, first you need to log in into the portal. Okay, so here in Pega, by default, they are creating one sample application and they are creating some sample operator IDs. So like how we will be having the operator IDs for us. So in the same way, even in Pega also, it is having some default credentials will be there. Okay, default operator ID will be there. The default operator ID is the administrator at pega.com. Okay, and for this administrator at pega.com, it will be having one default password also. Okay, so default administrator at pega.com is the default user ID, and install is the default password. INSTALL, install is the default password. Okay, so once if you click on login, then it is going to log in into the portal. And after logging into the portal, again by default for this operator ID, it will be having the access to the Pega sample application. As I said, so Pega will be having one default, one sample application for us with the default credentials. So even in future, if you want, you can refer this Pega sample application also, how exactly they meant it. Okay, so by referring that also, we can create our own application. Okay, but it may not be having in-depth everything, but at a high level, it will be having some default functionality in that. So by referring to that, okay, we can do this. Okay, so after logging into the portal, as I said, it will be having some default application Pega sample. So first of all, we should know what you mean by Pega sample. Okay, otherwise what you mean by application. Okay, so an application is a business solution that automates workflows in your organization. Multiple unrelated applications can be hosted in the same system. You create an application by running the new application wizard. Okay. So it's like a business solution. That means for ICICI Bank, okay, they have developed one application. So by which the operators are going to be accessing it. Okay, they can make their regular day-to-day work. Okay, as an employee, as a customer. Okay, so the features and the functionality will be different. So like from the employee perspective, what the operations he'll be making is different. From the end user perspective, from the customer perspective, what we will be performing is different. Okay, so as an employee, he'll be able to see all the customer details and he'll be making the needs, otherwise the requirement to what the customer needs on behalf of the customer, the employee is performing the action. Otherwise, if you directly log in into the portal as a customer, then you will be only able to access your application. Okay, you will be able to access only your details, and again you can make transactions on behalf of yourself only. Okay, so and that automates workflows in your organization. Multiple unrelated applications can be hosted in the same system. So even if you want, you can have multiple applications also in the same Pega environment. Like if you take any organization like ICICI Bank, if you take that, okay, what you will be doing? You will be having multiple applications. For example, for the home loan, you will be having one application. For the personal loan, you will be having one application. And even for the banking operations, you will be having one application. So likewise, you will be having different applications even in the same Pega environment. So, and they may be unrelated also. Okay, multiple unrelated applications. Why? Because home loan department is completely different with the banking operations and even with the personal. And even ICICI is also having the insurance functionality is there. So that is that portal also, it is completely different. And you create an application by running the new application wizard. So if you want to create an application in Pega, we'll be using the new application wizard by which we can create a new application. So we'll be going through how exactly we can create a new application. And why this Pega application platform mainly? So the Pega platform provides a single unified platform with everything you need to build or modify enterprise applications. Okay, by which we can build and modify the enterprise applications. That is what unified platform. So what is that unified platform? What do you mean by unified platform? So with the unified platform, you configure applications using a consistent set of components. The use of a consistent set of components reduces application development time. Okay, so here they are telling that we can configure the application using consistent set of components. So again, what do you mean by component? So here when we are going through that Pega platform, it provides a single unified platform. So we came to unified platform. Again, unified platform means what? Okay, it is a configure application using a consistent set of components. So what do you mean by component? Can anyone tell me what you mean by component? So a component means in the application, it will be having many number of the features. Each and every features we can develop it as a component. Okay, each and every feature we can develop it as a component. Means, for example, whenever you want to open the account in the ICICI Bank, so first of all, you have to give the your details like your name, address, city, state. Okay, all these things, date of birth, all these things you have to give. So we are going to enter our details. So that is like accepting the customer details is a one component. So we can make it as a component. Only that particular piece of the functionality, we can make it as a component. After that, okay, so we will be telling that whether you want to open the salary account, otherwise the savings account, otherwise the current account. So based on this again, okay, so they are going to be applying some kind of the constraints. Okay, some kind of the conditions. If it is a salary account, again, we have to enter your employer details, your salary. Okay, so all these information we have to give. Okay, so that is also, we can make it as a one component. For entering the personal details, okay, personal current account, we have to make it as a one more component. So by making it each and every functionality as a component, what it will happen, you know? So next time, whenever you want to implement the same functionality, instead of creating it again and again, the functionality, we can reuse it. A component is like a reusable piece of code which we can reuse in multiple applications, otherwise in the same application in multiple features also. Okay, that is what a component. So the use of consistent set of components reduces application development time. So why it is reducing the application development time? Why? Because as I said, we will be creating once and the same functionality we will be using across the organizations multiple times in multiple features. So because of that, it is going to reduce the time. So that is a unified platform. Okay. So, and coming to this Pega application platform, so unified platform with everything you need to build or modify enterprise applications. And business and IT stakeholders work together using visual models to capture business requirements. So here, business and IT stakeholders. So business means what? IT stakeholders means what? Means in general, whenever you want to start your project, so are we starting directly whatever I want? No. So what we will be doing? First of all, we will be approaching the people who is going to giving the business requirements. That means how exactly you should implement one user interface form, and again what are the fields you want to display in that form, and then what are the functionality you want to add in this particular application. So everything few people are going to provide for us. Okay, so those people are called product owners. Okay, those people are called product owners. So product owner is the one who is giving the requirements. Okay, and then IT stakeholders. IT stakeholders means from the development perspective. Okay, so there will be one person who is going to interacting with the business, like Scrum Master. Otherwise, we can also say business analyst. So business analyst is the one who is going to continuously interact with the product owner and to gathering the requirements. After gathering the requirements, this business analyst is going to give the requirements to the development team. Okay, so in the development team, again, we'll be having someone called Scrum Master, and then LSA, and then, okay, so the developers, the senior developers, all these people will be there. So the business analyst is giving the requirements to the, after gathering all the requirements from the product owners, he is giving it to the Scrum team, that is the IT stakeholders. So those people are going to work together. So by working all these people together, they can make it one application. So using visual models to capture the business requirements. So initially, even whenever the product owner gives, so we are going to preparing some mockups, okay, with the help of the developers. Okay, so this business analyst is going to develop one mockup. Okay, so that mockup is like a visual models to capture the business requirements. Why we have to create the mockup? Why? Because whenever you make it any mockup, so we can review it with the product owner again. So is it the requirements which you said, which you wanted to implement? So this is what our understanding. So if it is okay, then we will go ahead and we will start the development. So with no coding required, and the Pega platform automatically generates the application and its documentation. Okay, Pega platform automatically generates the application and its documentation. So likewise, this is the Pega platform mainly which we will follow to implement any application. So here, as I said that, okay, there are various roles will be there. Okay, in Pega, we are dividing into two kinds of the user roles. Building a successful business application requires collaboration between two parties, case participants and case designers. Okay, so we are going to dividing the total users in the development as a two parts, two types, two kinds of the user roles. Okay, case worker, case manager, again under the case participants, case designers. They are the business architect and again system architect. So you would be asking, case participants means and case designers means, okay, so the people who is going to be interacting. Okay, so the case participants are the business users of the applications. Okay, they are the business users of the application, processing and closing cases. So who will be processing and closing the case means the end users who is going to be accessing the application are the case participants, not the development team. They are the end users. As just now I said, okay, the customer is also a one case participant, and again employee of the bank is also a case participant. Case participants are usually organized by roles. For example, in a credit card dispute case, the roles might include a customer service representative, a dispute agent, and a fraud investigator. Okay, so for example, I have a credit card, so there is one transaction which is like a fraud investigation we need to do, so which is not done by me. Okay, so we will be raising a dispute for the transaction, then these people are going to be interacting it. So how? So first we will be making a call and telling that, okay, customer service to the customer service representative, this transaction is not done by me, so this is like a fraudulent transaction. So and then the dispute agent is coming into the picture. Okay, that agent is going to be check the dispute, and then the fraud investigator. So there will be one more person who is going to be investigating. So where exactly this transaction is done, how exactly this transaction is done. So like that, they are going to be performing it. And there are two groups of case participants, as I already shown you in the previous slide. Okay, case worker and again case manager. So what do you mean by case worker and what do you mean by case manager? Case workers are responsible for creating, viewing and working on their own cases and assignments. So that means once after raising the dispute, so we will be routing it to the few people. Why? Because in the organization, there may be around thousands of the disputes, otherwise lakhs of the disputes. So every dispute cannot be answered by one case worker itself. Only by one person cannot resolve all these things. Then what we will be doing? So what we will be doing is we will be routing few disputes to few people. Okay, so we are going to be segregating to few disputes to the few people. Okay, so they are responsible for creating, viewing and working on their own cases and assignments. So once if you raise a complaint, so they will be creating the dispute, and again they will only responsible for the disputes which they have raised it. So a case worker cannot monitor or manage work among other case workers or view work statistics. So that means if I am the case worker for one of the dispute, I can only responsible and I can only see the details about the disputes which are assigned to me or which are created by me. So I cannot see other disputes or other case details which are created by the other operators. And who are the case managers? Case managers are nothing but for each and every case worker, there will be one manager, okay, to monitor the status. So they are responsible for working on cases and monitoring work group status, goals and deadlines. So sometimes the case dispute has been raised today and it may go on for 1 week or 10 days. So in that case, the case manager is going to be checking the status, why he will be doing the follow-up, why it is taking more than 10 days. So what is the reason? Whether it is a valid reason, otherwise, so why exactly where it is lacking to resolve the issue. So working on cases and monitoring work group status, goals and deadlines. Case managers are also responsible for generating work manager reports. So they are also generating the reports, and again they will be checking. So on one particular day, how many number of the disputes are created, and on what one particular day, how many disputes are resolved. So what is the status? So everything he can see like that. So each case participant group uses a Pega runtime Pega portal specific to the group. Okay, only specific to that particular group. Case workers use the case worker portal. Case managers use the case manager portal. So that means each, based on the operator, as I said earlier also, the portal will be different. That means for the customer, only the related to the customer, that particular customer transactions which we can do, that can be seen on the portal. Whereas the employee portal will be different. Why? Because the employee need to access all the customer details. Whoever raising the dispute, he should be able to create the dispute on behalf of them. In case if you want to transfer the money from his account to any another person, otherwise if there is any deposit of the cash, so these things can be done, okay, by the employee of the ICICI Bank. So that portal will be different. So based on the operator, this portal will be different. Portal means, again I said, it's a website. Under the website, whatever you will be seeing, they are the features. Otherwise, the user interface will be different. So they are the case participants, mainly case worker and again case manager, who is going to be accessing the application. And coming to the case designers. So who are the case designers? So case designers are part of the delivery team responsible for designing and building business applications. That means the people who is going to be implementing the application, okay, with the requirements taken by the product owner, okay, which are given to the development team by the business analyst. So case designers use Pega's design time portals, Pega Express and Designer Studio. So here in the earlier, we have seen case worker portal and case manager portal based on the operators, based on their privileges. And coming to the case designers, there are three types of the people. Okay, case designers portal again will be different. So there are three types of the portals will be there. Case designers use Pega Design Time portal, Pega Express and Designer Studio. Okay, we will be seeing what exactly the difference of these three portals. So there are two groups of case designers. So under the case designers, again two types of the people will be there. As just now I explained, business architect, the first group of case designers work with case participants. Case participants means the end user. They are like a product owner who is going to give the requirements. Okay, work with the case participants and other stakeholders to define business objectives and application requirements. BAs plan application behavior to address the business objectives and requirements with specifications. Okay, so BA plan application behavior to address the business objectives and requirements with specifications. These specifications describe how the application manages and automates work. These specifications describe how the application manages and automates the work. So the BA is the main person who is gathering the business requirements. And then the system architects, the second group of case designers, okay, provide the technical skills needed to complete the applications. So they are the people who is going to be developing the application. So system architects configure application assets such as user interface forms, automated decisions, and correspondence. So SCS then review the application with business stakeholders for approval. Okay, then these people are going to take the business stakeholders for approval. So the SCA and the BS work together to ensure the new application reflects the business needs. So whatever we develop, okay, that is going to reflect the business needs. SCS often prototype application features to help refine the specifications captured by the BS. As I said, okay, mockups we will be creating, and then we will be going to be reviewing with the product owner. Okay, otherwise the case worker or case manager people. So whether what we understood and what we have created the mockups is the right way or not. So these prototypes help align the application with the business needs. So we are going to align with the application business needs. And again, the role of the system architect. Even under the system architect also, okay, so we will be defining into three parts. Okay, like system architect, senior system architect, and lead system architect. Okay, so the successful Pega application requires collaboration between three parties: business stakeholders, business architects, and system architect to solve the business problems. So business stakeholders define the business problem. Business problem means, as a product owner, as a end user, what exactly I want it. As a customer of the bank, what exactly he want it. He should be able to see his personal details, and he should be able to update his personal details. In case if I change my address, so I should be able to change my address, change my mail ID, change my phone number, like that. Okay, and from the employee perspective of the end user, okay, so he should be able to change the customer details. He should be able to access the customer details. Okay, so he should be able to transfer the money on behalf of the end user. So all these things will be comes under this. Okay, so business stakeholders define a business problem. Business architects plan the application to address the problem. System architects configure the application to resolve the problem. Okay, so first of all, he is going to define the business problem, business stakeholders, and then the architect, okay, plan the application to address the problem. Okay, business analyst is going to be address the problem, and then the system architect is going to be develop the application for the given problem. So to start, the business architects and business stakeholders outline business objectives and application requirements. So these two people together, okay, working with the product owner, okay, and define the business objectives and application requirements. The goal is to describe what the application must do to address the business problem. Okay, like this. And as I said, okay, there are mainly three types of the system architects is there. Okay, the first one is the system architect is the developer who is going to be develop the application. Okay, performs much of the development work. He will only do the development work. So SCS have the following responsibilities on a project, Pega project. Configure and unit test individual application elements such as correspondence and automated decisions. So once after gathering the requirements, so what we will be doing? Okay, based on the organization, we will be following the development methodology. So in general, you will be knowing about the waterfall methodology. Okay, so as you people knows that, okay, so maybe whether you are BTech or otherwise MCA, we would be heard about this waterfall method. And is there any other method available along with waterfall methodology?
It's agile.
Exactly.
Agile.
So, agile, or okay, we can say Scrum methodology.
Scrum
methodology. Okay. Exactly. Okay, so what is the difference between waterfall methodology and what is the difference between agile methodology? So if it is a waterfall methodology, Yeah, please go ahead. Someone was telling.
I just want to repeat this. I think the waterfall methodology, we will be doing everything at once and then we will go ahead, and then as I said, we will be doing step by step. So that's all.
Nice, exactly. So in the waterfall methodology, what happens, you know, first we will be gathering the complete requirements. That means for the bank, so whatever you want to implement, otherwise if you take any insurance company, so if you want to issue the insurance, okay, so the complete functionality, the complete requirements, the business analyst will take around, it may take 1 to 2 months. Okay, after that, what he will be doing, you know, he is giving that complete details to the business analyst will be giving the complete project information to the end user. So the end user, what he'll be doing, you know, he is going to implementing based on the requirements gathered by the business analyst. Okay, so but once after completing the project, okay, once you deliver the project to the end user, he may feel that, okay, this may not be the exact requirement what we followed, it may be little different. Okay, then what we have to do again, that will, the project will come back, we will be implementing the functionality. So that is the waterfall methodology. Okay, but we are in the agile methodology. So instead of taking the complete requirements at once, so at a high level, we will take a few of the requirements. Okay, like first we will be creating the user interface for creating the, for entering the customer details of the customer. Okay, so like that, okay, I'll be taking just some part of the application requirements, and again, I'll be developing it and I'll be giving, delivering it to the user. So just some part of the application we are developing, right? So for that we are taking, right, the requirements. So what we will do, we will be creating into some small pieces of the functionality into some small tasks. So each and every task we can make it as a one user story here. So in the Scrum methodology, in the Agile methodology, what we will be doing is, okay, we'll be making, we'll be dividing the functionality into some small part of the user stories. Okay, so by dividing into user stories, so we will be implementing. So in Agile methodology, so I'll be giving the complete picture of the Agile. Why? Because you may go with 2 years or 3 years of experience into the organization, right? So you should have the, you should also know about the Agile methodology. They'll be surely asking that, okay? So they'll be following that Agile methodology. So you should be aware of the Agile methodology. So in the Agile methodology, okay, we'll be having something called sprint. So what do you mean by sprint? A sprint will be around 2 to 3 weeks. So in some organizations, sprint will be having 2 weeks, and in some organizations, they may go with 3 weeks of the sprint. Okay, so first we will be taking, we will be starting sprint one with some of the things. Okay, so when the sprint started, what we'll be doing is, so as the business analyst already gathered the requirements, okay, so after gathering the requirements, what he'll be doing is, for each and every piece of the functionality, he'll be creating the user story and he'll be putting into the product backlog. So product backlog is the one where the user stories will be created and kept in the product backlog. And when the sprint started, what we will be doing is, from the product backlog, we'll be taking the user stories, and based on the capacity of the team, for example, in a team, we may be having 3 developers, otherwise 5 developers, otherwise 10 developers. The sprint is only 2 weeks. Okay, so if there are 3 developers, so based on the team capacity, from the product backlog, I'll be taking the user stories. For example, in the product backlog, it may be having 100 user stories. But when I have only 3 developers in the team, okay, that too, 2 weeks of the sprint. So within the 2 weeks, how many number of the stories I can complete? Only those many number of the user stories I will be taking, and again I will be starting the development. Are you clear? Are you understanding, or am I going fast?
Yes sir, I have a question. Like, user stories are in which form? Like, these are SQL queries or what? And
no,
like,
no.
Product backlog is kind of a database or what, where we
no.
store user stories?
Yeah, product backlog. Actually, to maintain the complete user stories, there are again some tools like Rally, otherwise project management framework. Okay, so like that, there are some tools which are third party tools available even in the Pega. Pega framework is there. Okay, so in the PMO, Pega management objectives. So in that also, we can create the user stories for each and every small piece of the functionality. We can create the user story. User story is nothing but Okay, it will be having the description like this only. So in the description, first story objective will be there. After the under the story objective, create the user interface for entering the customer details. And later, acceptance criteria will be there. Okay, under the acceptance criteria, they will be clearly explaining that, okay, what are the properties you want to display under the user stories. Okay, so like that, the user story will be there. Okay, so initially in the product backlog, they would be creating around 100 forms details, okay, 100 pieces of the functionality. Okay, they will be creating. And out of 100 user stories, okay, as I said, in the sprint, we can take only few user stories based on the team capacity. So if the 10 users are there, if again, based on the complexity of the user story, okay, they will be pulling the stories into the current sprint. Okay, in the current sprint, as I said, if I have 3 users, I will be taking 3 stories. If the complexity of the story is little bigger, okay, then only 3 stories I will take. Otherwise, sometimes just keeping labels, okay, and again some text boxes. So in that case, I will be taking customer form, and again, okay, so transfer money details. So for that also, one more form will be there. Otherwise, address change, one more form will be there. So I will be taking 2 stories. Why? Because it is just adding the properties into the form. So I'll be taking 2 stories. Otherwise, by one developer, 2 stories. And if you want to implement the functionality in such a way that after entering the customer details, that details I need to save into the database. Okay, I need to save it into the database. So for that, the complexity of the user and the user story is little bigger. So at that time, one developer will take only 1 story. Okay, so based on the complexity, one developer may take 1 story. Otherwise, if it is very simple story, then one developer may take 2 stories or 3 stories also. Okay, that tunnel we will be knowing how exactly we will be, okay, identifying the complexity. So the complete team will be decides the complexity, all these things like that. Okay, so at the end of this course, I will be explaining in detail about the agile methodology. Okay, right now, as I said that, okay, so business analyst, he is going to be creating the stories, and again when the sprint starts, we will be taking the user stories, and then we will be start working on that. Am I fine? Are you good?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So this system architect is only the person who is going to be only doing the development. He will not be doing any other job. Okay, and it helped draft the process and use interfaces during DCO sessions also. So DCO means direct capture objectives. Okay, direct capture objectives means what again? What do you mean by capture objectives? Objective of this development is what? Mainly to meet the business requirements, right? So to meet the business requirements, that is the objective. Okay, whenever the product owner gives any requirement, that is the objective. So through this DCO, direct capture objectives, what we will be doing is, okay, so based on the requirements given by the user, so we'll be creating some kind of the flow. Okay, in the flow, first to capture the customer details, and then validate the customer details, and then close it. Okay, that means create the account. So with that, it is one flow here, it will be followed. So in the DCO, we will be creating this flow, and again we will be going from beginning to the end of that particular flow. So he will be just drafting that process. And the senior system architect, who is the senior system architect? Okay, so SS says, okay, supervise development to the application. So whenever the development team develops any user stories, okay, they develop any functionality, they are going to supervise it. And SSS have the following responsibilities on the Prega project. So focus on a particular process or UI form and supervise the development of the process or form. And add technical details to specifications, translating application requirements into guardrail compliant future designs. Okay, so guardrails means what? Means whenever you are implementing anything, we have to follow certain standards. That standards are given by Pega. So they are called the guardrails. So the application, whenever you implement, we have to follow the guardrails compliance. It must be guardrail compliant. So in general, for anything, okay, we'll be having some rules will be there. Okay, So that rules in Pega, they are calling it as a guardrails. So that means in India, if you want to have a driving license, the person must have 18 years of age, and also he should be able to drive the vehicle, okay, under the test is going on. Okay, so in the testing, what they will do, how exactly he is operating the indicators and all these things. So that means for having the driving license, so these are certain conditions and certain standards we must have. In the same way, whenever you are implementing any of the application, you should follow some certain guardrails. Why we have to follow means, because of following the guardrails, your application performance will not be impacting. Okay, and even next time, if you want to add any new feature also, any extra features also, it will be easy. If you doesn't follow this, your application performance may be impacting. It may be working very slow, your application. And even in future, if you want to add any extra functionality into the existing functionality, it may not be supporting. So which will cause the rewrite of the entire application. Okay, by which your time waste, effort waste, and again money and cost also is going to be getting wasted. That is the thing. Okay, so that is the reason why whenever you implement any functionality, it should be guardrail compliant. And identify opportunities to reuse existing assets with the application design. As I said, we should be able to reuse any of the functionality which we implemented. So whenever the developer develops any of the feature, so he'll be checking whether it is reusability is possible into the existing application or not. Okay, and the third one is the lead system architects. Okay, so what is the purpose of this lead system architect role? So LSS are the most experienced system architects. LSS have the following responsibilities on a Pega project. So direct the technical effort on the project. Okay, so these people are directing these system architects, senior system architects, and work with business architects with BS to design the application architecture. Okay, so once the business analyst gathers the requirements, okay, these people are designing the application. Okay, how exactly the user interface must be there. Okay, from the first screen, how exactly it should go to the second screen. So is there any routing functionality? So how exactly you can route it? So the complete designing will be done by the lead system architects. And design the architecture to reuse application assets as much as possible. So even he is also taking care of, at the time of designing itself, whether the reusability is possible or not, how exactly we can reuse it. So that he is going to design it. And later, based on this design, this system architect will be developing. So once the system architect develops it, the senior system architect will be verifying it, whether he developed the functionality, okay, according to the design by the lead system architect, and meet quality goals, including application performance. So, and he is also specifying it, okay, whether it is meet the quality goals or including application performance. All these things will be done by the lead system architect. And even once you have done the course also, okay, there are three certifications we'll be doing. As I already told you, certified system architect, one kind of the certification we'll be doing. Okay, senior system architect, certified senior system architect, that is also one kind of the certification which we'll be doing. And again, based on your experience, okay, so we will be also writing lead system architect certification also. Okay, so these are the three certifications which we'll be doing. Okay, so this is from the development perspective. And what about the business architect perspective? Even for the business architect perspective also, okay, certified business architect certification will be there. That certification will be done by the business architect. Okay, so there are the three system architects will be there. Okay, and after that, allowing a user to access an application. Okay, how exactly you can allow a user to access an application? To allow a user to access an application, you add the appropriate access group to the user's operator ID record. So whenever you are logging into the application, there are mainly three types, sorry, there are various operators will be there. As I said, that employee is a different kind of the operator. Okay, and also customer is a different kind of the operator. And also manager also a different kind of the operator. Okay, so like that. So here various operators will be created, and they are like application colon administrator, authors, managers, users. Okay, so administrators means what? Developer access to the application configured to open the application in Designer Studio. And the developer access to the application configured to open the application in Pega Express. So authors means like a business analyst, so they will be accessing through the Pega Express. Okay, administrator will be accessing the portal through the Designer Studio. And even the manager access to the application configured to open the application in the case manager portal. And the users are like case user portal. So based on their roles, so the operator IDs will be created and the portal will be different. Their access level also will be different. Okay, so they are the mainly four types of the operators which we will be deciding. And as I said earlier also, to implement the development of the application, what we'll be doing. So we will be first to start in the application. Okay, we'll be first to start in the Pega server. Okay, so by selecting 8.5.1 startup, Pega platform 8.5.1 startup. So once after starting up the server, then we will be having Pega platform 8.5.1 login. So once if you click that, it will be open the portal. In the portal, what we have given administrator at pega.com. So this is the one of the portal, okay, which we have logged in, which we can log in, administrator at pega.com. So he is the whole and soul of the application. So for this administrator at pega.com, so there is a one default application has been created, Pega platform. Okay, Pega platform is the one of the default application which is assigned for administrator at pega.com. Okay, so and once after completing your work, in general what you will be doing, whether it is your Gmail ID or whether it is the icicibank.com, otherwise whether it is amazon.in, so what you will be doing, once after completing your tasks, we are going to be log out. Okay, so to log out the application, here based on your operator ID, here it will be having one operator ID icon. Okay, A indicates here administrator at pega.com operator ID. So after completing your work in the portal, what we can do is here we can select this operator ID, and once after selecting that, you will be seeing log off. So in general, even for ICICI Bank, what we will be seeing, whether it will be log off, otherwise sign out. Okay, sign out, otherwise log off, both are same. So we will be coming out from that application. Okay, so again you will be coming to the home page where exactly you can give the operator ID credentials, otherwise you can log in. So if it is the same operator ID, by giving the same thing you can log in. Otherwise if it is different operator ID, we can change this operator ID credentials, and again we can log in into the portal. Okay, so I have done with my job. Okay, I have completed that. Okay, then what you can do, in general we will be shutting down the laptop. But here you should not shut down the laptop directly or your desktop directly. Why? Because already there is one Pega portal. Okay, Pega platform 8.1.5.1 startup. So already this Pega server is running in your local machine. Okay, so which is accessing by you, on which you will be okay, implementing the application. Okay, so this server will be abruptly closing the application when you shut down the laptop directly. So what we have to do here, we have something called Pega platform 8.5.1 shutdown. So first we will be shut down this server, and then we will be shut down the laptop. Okay, so that is the best way. So why, in case if you directly shut down the laptop, what happens? Okay, what happens means it is going to abruptly closing your server, which may not work next time when you want to start the Pega server. So it's better to do the proper shutdown of your Pega server, and then you can go and shut down your laptop. So this is the way we have to log in and log off into the Pega portal and then your laptop. Okay, so and it will clearly give you that the shutdown process is completed, and you can close it. So once after getting that message here, then only you can close this command prompt, and then you can shut down your laptop. So this is about the operators, okay, the users who is going to be working on the Pega application, all these things. So if people has any doubts, any queries, so can you tell me?
I'm trying to start up these things, sir. Like before it is fine, but now it is not starting up. Like the local host is not opening. Like is,
okay.
what can be the problem?
So local host is not running means so your server has not started properly.
Okay.
Okay.
So
yeah. Which version is it? That one, when did you install it?
Oh, I think I installed 1 month back. I think 8.5.1.
Okay. So after that, have you made any changes in your laptop, like port ID, otherwise changing, otherwise have you installed any other software kind of the things like that?
No, is it okay that I can use some other like connection? Wi-Fi connection is not applicable. Is it mandated to use the same thing, or we can change it?
Wi-Fi is not required. Why? Because your server is in your local system itself, right? Local laptop itself, right? So
okay.
Wi-Fi is required. So in case if you want to connect to the different server like Amazon, which is placed in some other location, then we need it Wi-Fi. Okay, even in the organizations also, when you go, your server may be somewhere else. So there it is required to connect your either intranet, otherwise your Wi-Fi. Then
VPN.
Exactly, VPN connection if you have. So if you want to connect to the VPN also, you should have the Wi-Fi. Otherwise your internet connection must be there. Then only you
okay.
will be able to. For this local, you need not have any Wi-Fi or internet connection. Directly you can start this server, and then through this local host also, you can, it will be work. Login. But sometimes what happens, you know, even though your server is in your local machine, still you are not able to access it. So it indicates there is something has been installed which has impacted your Pega server. So that is the reason why you are not able to access it. Okay.
Yeah,
so
okay.
And when you start up the server, here in the command prompt, you would be able to see if there are any errors is occurring or not. Okay, so if there are any errors occurred also, you will be not be able to log in into that your local portal. So check that if there are any errors. So if there are any errors, so maybe, okay, so next time when you are installing any other software, be careful. Okay, so here, what you can do is we can even uninstall and again create the Pega software again. So how you can uninstall means mainly whenever you install, you will be having these three icons, right? So you delete these three icons. And later in your local computer, where exactly you installed your Pega software. So I installed my Pega software in C drive, pega.py. Okay, you can shift to delete it. Okay, and after you shift to delete it, okay, again, where exactly your software is there. Okay, my software is under the C drive, Pega trainings mine. Okay, so you can go to this pega.py. Sorry, here it's there in the Pega software. So once after opening this, okay, you need to select install. Okay, by selecting this install, so and after that it will be having very normal process only. So just next to where exactly you want to install your software. So as I said earlier, I installed my software in cdrivepega.a.py. Okay, so like that it will be having all these things. So direct steps will be there. You can just select next steps and you can create the software. Okay, so this is like uninstall and again install the software through install. Okay. Anything else by anyone?
So, can I share my screen now, like to install that software in my system, or we'll do it later?
Yeah, Jagadish, do you have any questions? If you are fine, then I'll go with Pratik. So, what is he facing? I think some issue, right?
Yes, sir.
No, I don't have any questions. You can help Pratik, sir. Hello? 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 Hello. Are you able to hear me? Hello.
Yeah, Jagdish, I can hear you.
So I don't have any questions. So I can go with the installation.
No, no, I'm not sure. I think okay. Sari is not able to listen.
Okay.
It's like I'm the only one who is facing some difficulties while having the conversation with sir, or you guys are also facing some problems with internet? Like in between the conversation, are there some... Hello?
No, no, I think we just spoke only a couple of times, but we didn't face an issue.
Okay. I think
right
last...
now, yeah, we lost him.
Okay, I don't know why exactly for 1 hour. Okay, if you have queries, yeah, we will go with you. Otherwise, let me check with Pratik.
Yeah, yes, sir, you can check with Pratik. I don't have any questions.
Okay, thank you, Jagdish. Yeah, Pratik, please.
Yes, sir.